This lecture is about the human body tissue, as the human body is made up of different type of cells. So cell is the basic fundamental unit of life. Human body is composed of trillions of cells. So the cells, when they group together in an organized way, they form the tissues. And tissues then form the system, and these systems collectively form the human body. So tissue, what is tissue? Tissues are basically the group of cells. When the group of cells combine together, they form the tissues. So the cell, the individual cell has the specific function. Cell is the basic fundamental unit of life. Each individual cell has the specific functions that are involved in the, that carry the nutrients and convert the food into energy and perform the specific functions. So the same type of cells, when the individual cell and together with the same type of cells that are having the same function and the same size and the same type of cells, when they combine together, they perform the more specialized functions. So these group of cells together are known as tissues. So the human body is made up of different type of tissues. So tissues are classified according to the size, shape, and different functions. So there are four different types of tissues in the human body. They are the epithelial tissue, connective tissue, muscle tissue, and nervous tissue. So these tissues are classified on the basis of their location, on the basis of their function, and on the basis of their shape, and on the basis of the cells they contain. So the epithelial tissue. Epithelial tissue is the most outermost covering of the human body is made up of epithelial tissue. So epithelial tissue, it lines the outermost covering, like it also, you can say that it provides the protective boundaries to the human body. It lines the human body to the external surfaces and also to the internal organs of the human body. To the external protection, the example is the skin, and the internal, it also lines the internal organs of the body. So epithelial cells, it is a thin lining that provides the protection, and it's the outermost surface of the human body, and it also lines the internal organs of the human body. So epithelial tissue is also involved in the, as it is a thin lining and it surrounds the different organs of the human body, and so they are involved in the transport and exchange of ions and different materials within the different organs of the human body. The other is the connective tissue. So connective tissue, as the name indicates, that it connects the different tissues of the human body, as the connective tissue is in, it consists of, it is made up of different types of cells, and it also contains the fibers, and it also contains the medium. So it connects the different tissues of the human body, and it also involved in the, it also provides the supports to different organs of the body, as the example is the cartilage, as it is involved in the, provides the support and protection to the bone. Other is the muscle tissue. The third type of tissue is the muscle tissue. So muscle tissue, it is involved in the contraction and relaxation. So because of the muscle tissue, the human body organs are able to perform the movement. So the movement inside the human body occurs through the contraction and relaxation of the muscle tissues. So muscle tissues are of three types, that it are not only provides the external movement, not only the movement of the muscles of the skeletal muscles, but also involved in the contraction and relaxation of the internal organs. As the movement of materials inside the internal organs inside the human body, they are also performed through the contraction and relaxation by the muscle tissues. The other type of tissue is the nervous tissue. Nervous tissue, it basically forms the nervous system that is involved in the formation of neurons and the spinal cord. So all the information and activities carried out by the, all the activities carried out by the human body, they are occurs through the transmission of nerve impulses. So nerve impulses are carried out through these nervous tissues. So they conduct nerve impulses to perform different activities of the human body. So these are the four, these are the tissues and the four different types of tissues. In the next lectures, we are going to study about the each